Hi, I'm Bob. Welcome back to the step-by-step tutorial of the textbook Microeconomics, Theory and Applications with Calculus by Professor Jeffrey Perloff. I will provide detailed solutions to the exercises for part 2 of chapter 2. It is about supply. You can watch my introductory microeconomics course if you want to review the topic before doing the exercises. You can find the link below. Let's solve exercise 2.1. The estimated supply function for processed pork in Canada is Q equals 178 plus 40 times P minus 60 times pH, where quantity is in millions of kilograms per year, and the prices are in Canadian dollars per kilogram. How does the supply function change if the price of hogs doubles from $1.5 to $3 per kilogram? We can substitute the values of the hogs price into the equation and write the quantity of pork supplied as a function of its price. The supply curve shifts to the left. By the way, we set the price equal to zero in the original supply function to find the intersection point with the quantity x-axis. And we set the quantity equal to zero in the new supply function to find the intersection point with the price y-axis. The new supply curve has a kink. The quantity supplied is zero when the price is below $0.05. Let's do exercise 2.2. Given an estimated supply function for avocados of Q equals 58 plus 15 times P minus 20 times PF. Determine how much the supply curve for avocados shifts if the price of fertilizer rises from $0.4 to $1.5 per pound. Illustrate this shift in a diagram. First, we substitute the fertilizer prices into the equation to find the supply functions. Second, we draw the supply curves. The supply functions are linear, so the corresponding supply curves are straight lines. The slopes are positive, so the supply curves slope upwards. The slopes are the same for the two supply functions, so the increase in the fertilizer price causes a parallel shift to the left. To find the intersection points with the quantity x-axis, we just need to set the price equal to zero in the supply functions. Or we can do it this way. We differentiate the quantity supplied with respect to the price of fertilizer. It is minus 20. Thus, an increase of $1.1 in the fertilizer price results in a decrease of 22 units in the supply. Let's look at exercise 2.3. If the US supply function for corn is QA equals 10 plus 10 times P, and the supply function for the rest of the world for corn is QR equals 5 plus 20 times P, what is the world supply function? The total supply is the horizontal sum of the US supply and the rest of the world's supply. total equals 15 plus 30 times P. We can illustrate it in a diagram. We find the intersection of the supply curve and the quantity XSS by setting the price equal to zero. Because the total supply curve is the horizontal sum of the US and the rest of the world's supply curves, the total supply curve is flatter than each of the other two supply curves. Let's solve exercise 2.4. Between 1971 and 2006, the United States from time to time imposed quotas or other restrictions on importing steel. A quota says that no more than Q bar units of steel can be imported into the country. Suppose both the domestic supply curve of steel SD and the foreign supply curve of steel for sale in the United States SF are upward sloping straight lines. How did a quota set by the United States on foreign steel imports of Cuba affect the total US supply curve for steel? First, we draw the total supply curve without the quota. It is the horizontal sum of the domestic and the foreign supply curves. For example, at price P1, the domestic supply is QD and the foreign supply is QF. The sum of quantities supplied at that price is QT. Therefore, the total supply curve is ST without the quota. Second, with the quota equal to Q bar for the foreign supply, the foreign supply curve has a kink at the corresponding price of P star. The foreign supply is fixed at Q bar above the price P star, which is a vertical line for that part of the foreign supply. As a result, the total supply also has a kink at the price P star. Below the price P star, the total supply is the horizontal sum of the domestic and the foreign supply. Above the price P star, the total supply curve is just the domestic supply curve shifted to the right by Q bar units. Let's do exercise 2.5. A cartoon in this chapter shows two people in front of a swimming pool discussing whether they want to go swimming. How does colder weather in the winter affect the desire of people to go swimming? Does it cause a movement along the demand curve or shift of the demand curve? Use a figure to illustrate your answer. This exercise is about demand. First, it is important to distinguish between a movement along a demand curve and a shift of the demand curve. Usually, the demand curve describes the quantity demanded as a function of the price of that good, holding other factors constant. When the price changes, the change in the quantity demanded reflects a movement along the demand curve. When the factors other than the goods price change, the entire demand curve shifts. These other factors affecting demand include consumer tastes, income, the price of other goods, and government rules and regulations. In this exercise, weather is a factor that influences people's demand for swimming. It causes the demand curve to shift to the left. For any given price of swimming, the quantity of swimming demanded reduces because of the cold weather. We can illustrate it in a diagram. Suppose the price of swimming drops from P1 to P2. If the weather is unchanged, the quantity of swimming demanded will increase from Q1 to Q2. However, the cold weather shifts the demand curve to the left from D1 to D2. The new quantity demanded is Q3. We see that even with a lower price of P2, the demand for swimming in winter is probably smaller than the original demand Q1 in summer. Thank you so much for solving the exercises with me. Practicing the exercises is an essential way to learn microeconomics. See you soon in the next part of Chapter 2. Goodbye. Thank you for watching this video and subscribing to my YouTube channel. See you next time.